We pray for blessings. We pray for peace. Comfort for family. Protection while we sleep. We pray for healing. For prosperity. We pray for your mighty hand to ease our suffering.
And all the while you hear each spoken need, your love is way too much to give us lesser things.
'Cause what if your blessings come to raindrops? What if your healing comes to tears? What if a thousand sleepless nights are what it takes to know you're near? What if trials of this life are your mercies in disguise? We pray for wisdom, your voice to hear. We cry in anger when we cannot feel you near. We doubt your goodness, we doubt your love, as if every promise from you
Happy 31st anniversary, Muscat Seventh-day Adventist Church. I am praising God for this church and the way God has used it to bless me and so many others over the years. May this Muscat Seventh-day Adventist Church continue to develop and do the Lord's work. May its ministry continue for years to come. God bless and wishing you all the best in your work. Missing you all. Bye!
I also want to tell you, you know, that the word of God in Mark 8:28 says that if anyone is ashamed of me and my words in this adulterous and sinful generation, the Son of Man will be ashamed of them when he comes in his Father's glory with the holy angels. So let us not be ashamed. Let us not be bashful to come forward and praise God for what he has done for us as individuals or for us as a church family. I would like to start by saying, you know, that this year has been a year of, I won't say stressful, but there have been times of anxiety. And, you know, we have not been sure what's happening. But one thing we have absolutely certain is that God has been faithful to us as a family. You know, we know not what the future holds, but we most definitely know who holds the future. And that has taken us through. And even though the situation has been such, you know, we as a family can praise God for certain things. Nalindra has been able to enter a university for which we praise God. He is enjoying Sri Lanka now because he still misses Oman, but we praise God that he has settled down. But, you know, we never realize how God works, you know. Last year, my sister decided to retire and return to Sri Lanka. And everybody was wondering why on earth would she make such a decision? She was doing very well in the UK. She was having a good practice. And, you know, we also didn't understand it. But in mid-January, she returned. And, you know, looking back, we can praise God that that was a decision that God directed him. And I'm sure every one of us have seen this. We have not understood why things have happened, but we have seen God coming through and we have understood what has happened. So, you know, one of my favorite texts, Psalms 139:16, before you were even born, God had planned it all for you. That has been a source of assurance for us as a family. One thing I've also learned, you know, I am technologically disabled. But because of the necessity to come online and for people like who have, you know, taught me, I'm now a little able to manage my way through Zoom and WebEx and things like that, which has been a blessing, We've been able to have Bible studies online, to talk to people, not of the church family, but, you know, and this has been a great blessing. I also want to thank God for the church family who has supported one another. I mean, it's amazing how the church family has come through at this time. And all I want to say is, be faithful. God has been faithful, and as much as he has been faithful, let us be faithful. And the joy of salvation is ours for certain. So at this time, the platform is open. If anyone would like to unmute and open their video and share a testimony in praise and honor of God, they're most welcome to do so. I would also say that if you're uncomfortable with opening your video and you would like to just unmute and talk, That's fine. But if you would like to open your video, that would be nice as well. So the platform is open. Please come in and share your testimony at this time.
Hello. Hello, church. Hello, can you hear me?
Hello, happy Sabbath. We can hear you.
Yes, we can hear you loud and clear. Come through, please.
Okay, happy Sabbath to all of us and happy New Year. I want to share my testimony to all of you, to all of us. First of all, I praise and thank God for His goodness in my life. And I'm thankful for His greatest love for all of us is the family and for my family too. He leads me into righteousness. He opened my eyes, my mind, my heart to see more truths. I'm thankful today for the privilege to share my personal testimony. I want to share the goodness of the Lord in my life. I started with a desire. Sometimes in January 2002, I got a desire in my heart. I wanted to know who will go to heaven. I was a Catholic at this time, at my age of 31 years old. This desire arose me, my heart. With that desire, God led me to know the truth. That time, somebody invited me to a Bible study. During that Bible study, God opened my eyes, my heart, to the truth about salvation. The only way to salvation is Jesus Christ. And the Bible verse that opens my eyes is John 14:6. It says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. Only through Jesus Christ, people can be saved. So when I heard this verse, I accepted it and received it. And I accepted the Lord Jesus as my personal Lord and Savior. It was September 21, 2002. I got baptized on November 1, 2002 by immersion in Oman Evangelical Christian Church here in Gala, Oman. So from 2002, I worship the Lord and serve Him with all my heart together with my family until the year 2019, something happened. I joined Seventh-day Adventist Muscat, Oman. Why? What is the reason for transferring from evangelical faith to Seventh-day Adventist? Let me explain. Before I joined SDA, sometime in the year 2016, as I studied the Word of God, I study Revelation and the word mark of the beast, image of the beast, the number of the beast. That Bible verses gives me a deep desire to know what is the meaning of that words. Because throughout my 15 years of worship the Lord and studying His word in evangelical denominations, nobody explained that verse properly. And in my mind, I want to know the meaning of that words. The mark of the beast, because the warning of the third angel's message is very dangerous. With that deep desire in my heart, once again, God leads me to unlock the meaning of that verses. God leads me to God leads me what to do. Watching YouTube, I watch different preachers explaining mark of the beast. Image of the beast, the number of his name. One preacher impressed me about his interpretation. That preacher name, Pastor Stephen Bohr. I don't know him personally, but I followed him, his teaching, because as I study also my Bible, I confirm that he is correct with his interpretations. And finally, almost 3 years of studying Bible through YouTube with Pastor Stephen Bohr, I understand the true meaning of the word beast, mark of the beast, and his image. As I understand this truth, the only way to counter the beast is worship the Creator through observing the Sabbath of the Lord. So I decided to worship my God, my Creator, on his holy day, the Sabbath of the Lord. So on September 2019, me and my family joined Seventh-day Adventist Muscat, Oman, to worship God, my Creator, on his holy day. And I have joy in my heart knowing the one I have worshiped is my Creator and my God. So from September 2019, worshiping and studying the Lord with SDE brothers and sisters, I grew more and gained more knowledge and understanding concerning the second coming of Jesus Christ. Jesus gave us a sign before his coming, and one of the sign is Sunday law, the mark of the beast. And the Sunday law is almost here. So for this knowledge and understanding and wisdom God gave me concerning the mark of the beast is a greatest blessings of all blessings for me. So I praise God for his blessings, wisdom, knowledge, and understanding for me. That's my testimony to all of you SDA Church. Praise God. Amen.
The part, Brother Wilson. Thank you, Brother Efren.
Efren, for that testimony, which is such an encouragement to us. You know, sometimes we wonder about social media, but God led you through YouTube, and we praise God for that. At that time, I think Wilson. Brother, pardon me. Yes, yeah. Their hands are up. Yes, that's a good idea. If you would like to come on, please raise your hand when you'd like to come through so that William can monitor it. Thank you.
Good evening. Happy Sabbath, Church family. It's a great privilege to have this here, the testimony. One of my favorite books is found in 1 John chapter 4, verses 7 to 12, which says, "Dear friends, let us love one another, for love comes from God. Everyone who loves has been born of God and knows God. Whoever loves does not know God, because God is love. This is how God showed his love among us. He sent his one and only Son into the world, that we might live through him. This is love, not that we loved God, but he loved us and sent his Son as a sacrifice for our sins. Dear friend, since God so loved us, we also ought to love one another. No one has ever seen God, but if we love one another, God lives in us and his love is made complete in us." So here we are here to represent God's love, whoever come and contact with us. Though the COVID has totally distorted everything, but we had the connection with God for throughout the week. We have the Bible study from Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, then the Sabbath Friday, Vespers service, and Saturday. So we continue studying. It has been a great privilege and a great blessing for all of us to study the Word of God through many who participate, who contribute to these studies. And we are much thankful to God for His protection in care and all the blessings, bountiful blessings that He gives to us. And this moment, we also like to give our thanks to every one of in the church, and also our children, Kevin and Kylie, also send their greeting to the church. And during this year that we met a couple of people in our house, I mean, they came to see us. I believe that God has sent them so that we were able to share the good news with them. So my wife will tell the story shortly.
I thank God for 2020 and for keeping us away from all sicknesses. And as we began 2020, it was so difficult to cope up with this coronavirus. This is the first time I ever did not want to work. And I served this country for 25 years. And that is the first time I thought I must go home. But God allowed me to take some leave. That is, I think, out of love. Me and another girl only from the our unit got annual leave of 4 weeks during that critical time. And that 4 weeks taught me that I must stay for this country and the people to combat COVID-19. So I was able to get back to work. And also, I had my surgery and it was uneventful, and I'm back to normal. And during this period, there was two of the nurses, somebody has directed them to our house, and they wanted to learn about God more. And Bala, as he was clearing his house, he had lots of primary, kindergarten, junior, primary, kindergarten, Sabbath school books. I also had 2020, all the new Bible, new Sabbath school books. So when they asked us for reading material, it was ready in hand to give them. There's a Hindu girl who listened to us. She said, I wanted to learn more about Jesus, so give me some material to read. So we were able to give a Bible and some material. And an Omani girl who wanted to learn about Bible, and she wants to compare Quran, and she wants to know more about Bible. So I was able to give a Bible, and she is still in contact with me. Meanwhile, there was a Nigerian boy who just happened to contact, and I don't know, I felt that I should help him. And I was able to, with the God's help, with prayer, raise some fund to get him out of his problem. And also, he also asked some books and materials to read more about God. So we were able to distribute all those books to those needy Bible who were hunger for God's word. So I think and I pray that these three people will join the church as our church reopens for everyone. So I thank God for the privilege that we could able to talk to these people who really wants to know about Christ. And even when we go back, this is our mission, that we want to serve God. So keep us in prayers. And I thank God for this church, especially for helping to mentor our children who are serving God in different ways. And Kevin is doing a wonderful job for God. And Kylie being in the mission working, and she's also doing more service to the Lord. And I ask all these children who are growing in the church, I dedicate all these children of our church that they keep God as the God in priority in whatever they do. And I see As we saw yesterday, our children around the world doing good, and I wish our children to be faithful and serve God, because then as parents, wherever you are, you can rest and you can be at peace. You know that God, they are serving God and they are with God. God will protect them as He has protected all of us. Thank you.
Thank you, sister. We've got Sheba followed by Sister Deba. Sister Sheba followed by Deba. Unmute, Sister Sheba.
Hello.
Good evening and happy Sabbath to all of you.
Good evening and happy Sabbath.
Good evening and happy Sabbath. We can hear you loud and clear.
Okay. Camera. Can you see us?
Yes, we can see you and hear you loud and clear.
Thank you. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, God. Thanks for God for giving us this opportunity. Last year, it was a very challenging year, though it was for everybody, though it was going through a tough situation. We were able to be more close to God with our Bible studies and all those things. God has given an opportunity for us to be with God. That is something great that we have not expected, though it was a tough situation. But nearing to God was very much nearer. And one most important thing I just wanted to say, that my passport was held up in the court of Oman for no reason. There was some product which we brought and it was stuck up, and the consumer court, they have taken my civil ID and as well as my passport, and I was without civil ID and passport, without civil ID for 3-4 months. Then passport, 1 year, 10 months I was without my passport. So I was going through a tough situation. I have been asking our church member also, was praying, Surendra Anna, Selvi, many people, Reggie and all were praying for us. And the many other people also was struck up with some of the 3-4 companies were struck up. They were not able to get the passport, but automatically their passport was within a year, it was released. But unfortunately, I don't know why it was got delayed, my passport. And we were praying, praise God, praise, thank you Lord for His mercy. Thank you Lord for His perfect guiding us. And last month, I got my passport. And the court, which I got the case, that also not the normal civil case. It was a criminal case. They have put the consumer protection. And last month, they have said that I am free from all those things. There is no case against me. And they released my passport. And one more case, it was in Sumail, the same case. There also, they released my Omani's passport. And whatever we have given, the deposit, they have given back. It is purely, it is God's mercy, intervention. We have been praying how God has led us in a correct way. Earlier, for 6 months, we were going through a difficult situation. Then we prayed, then we understood that God has got a plan for each and everything. And God, in His own time, He has released the passport and everything. This time, I just wanted to read the verses, Isaiah chapter 41, verse 10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. Yes, I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. So God was absolutely in our family like this. Fear not, I am with you. It was a promise. It has gone promise. We always, every day we used to pray, but it was happened. It was too, my God, I cannot explain how the God has led us in a way where it is an unbelievable way. It has given us the passport and many other things also in the officially also. It was a challenging. God has led us in a right way. And I'm thankful to God for all his mercy. And I would like to say one more verses Proverbs chapter 3, verse 5 and 6. Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your understanding. In all your ways, acknowledge him and he shall direct your path. It is absolutely in our life, it was that. And Sheba also wants to say about her school also. She has gone through, she will share that.
Actually, since I'm dealing with the kindergarten, when the lockdown happened, the number of children registered slashed down to more than half. But God's mercy was upon us. In fact, all the kindergarten teachers, we thought we'll all lose the job. Yes, and but although it was slashed down to more than half, the principal stood firm saying that even if it is only 10 children, my teachers will teach even those 10 children online. But God's grace, we had 40 children, which used to be 80. And they continued even the second term. And she was able to bring back some of the assistant teachers and nannies. And kept safe, kept all of us safe from this pandemic, from last December till now. It's nothing but God's grace. I want to thank God that
for his mercy and keeping us safe, and our church family also. Thank you, God, for keeping us safe. May God bless everyone and keep safe, and may his protection be upon each and every one. And we pray for people who are working in hospitals also. Bless them, God. Amen.
Thank you, Sheba and Sham. We've got Sister Deepa, and followed by Emmanuel.
Good evening, everyone.
Sister Deepa, I can see you, and you are loud and clear.
Yes, thank you, brother. Yes, first of all, wish you all a very happy and blessed New Year. 2020 might have been the worst year for the majority of the people, but for our family, it was an amazing journey with Jesus. In 2020, we have received abundance of blessings from Lord. Whatever we thought of impossible, God made them possible. I want to share two major testimonies with you all. First one is about our spiritual growth. During this lockdown period, we could spend most of our times with God. As a family, we had Bible studies and we could finish many chapters in Bible and learned many lessons. Really, our journey with God is a marvelous experience. We thank God for allowing us to taste his rich blessings. And then during April, we had a thought of having Bible study with our extended family members in back home through Zoom app. By God's grace, it worked out. Successfully, we are conducting family prayer meeting with back home members every day for more than now 8 months now. It's really a great blessing. We praise God for that. Now some of our non-Christian family members also joining us for this Bible study. We praise God for this opportunity. At least we get a chance to share our good news with non-Christian people also. And then my second testimony is about our job. Like in our company, more than 1,500 people were lost their jobs during this pandemic. But God secured both of our jobs, myself and Bala's jobs. And God blessed us we shifted to a new spacious company accommodation and a new car, which we thought of, as impossible, but God takes care of us. We praise God for all his blessings upon us and praise the Lord. Amen.
Sister, Brother Emmanuel, and followed by Sanran's parents.
Good evening and happy new year. Can you
hear me? Yes, I can hear, but we can't see you.
Okay, let me just put the video on. Okay, can you see me now?
Not yet, but go ahead with the testimony, my brother.
All right. I just want to start by saying COVID came upon us when I was just 3 months in Oman, having arrived from Africa, and that was the first time in about 17 years having separated from my family. It was a very unexpected event, and I booked flights twice, intending to go back home to be with my family, but it all failed, and that took me through a very difficult time. But I just want to quote a phrase from Elder Sirendra's prayer today, where he said, through it all, it was God who saw us through. I can testify to say it was not easy for me. It was not easy for my wife and for my children. That period of separation without me able to go there was not easy, but it was God who saw us through it all. And this year has been a tough year for everyone. I just want to thank God because we are alive, we are healthy. This disease has taken many people. Many are getting sick and being hospitalized. I think we are watching the news. It's not yet over, but we believe, and I believe, that God is still in charge of the situation. And all these things, we understand them, how they happened, why they happened, by and by. But the good thing is God has taken us into another year, and we must continue to serve him, to worship him, and to praise him. As we were nearing, this is the last part of my testimony, as we were nearing the end of this year, just a couple of days before Christmas, something that was very unexpected happened to me and to my family. By my family here, I'm referring to my immediate family, my parents, my siblings, and everyone in the greater family. Some 10 years or so ago, one of my brothers decided to cut himself off the family. He is a married man with children. He is actually the brother that looked after me during my school years until I got married. I was coming from his house, and he decided to cut himself off. For all these years, it was just a few days before Christmas that he decided to reveal himself to the family again. And we got reunited. It was under difficult circumstances that we got reunited as well, because it was when his wife, my sister-in-law, had passed away. And she was buried on Christmas Day on the 25th, back in Zimbabwe. But I want to thank God because he is back in the family. We are now communicating with everyone else. He is even added in the family WhatsApp group after so many years. Up to now, we don't understand what happened to him. We don't have the details of what has been happening to him all these years. But what we are happy about, what I am happy about, is that he is back in the family together with his 4 children. Now he has 2 grandchildren that we also met for the first time. So I will forever praise God for the end of this year. And this year has passed, but let us look forward. God has good things in store for us. And the only text that I felt would suit this moment in time is Psalms 23, because we have gone through a lot, all of us. And in one way or another, God has done great things for us. God has done great things for me and for my family. And just in closing, I thank God, because even though I failed to travel totally in 2020 to Botswana, God made it possible for my family to travel to Oman. And they've been with me here for the past 4 weeks. They will be traveling back next week. And I thank God for the time that I've had with them, and I'm still having with them. Physically, we are together. It was not easy for them to travel. It took about 4 days on the way because of the connections and due to the COVID situation. But they are here, and they are all safe and sound and healthy. Thank you, Church, for the Church family that has been supporting me. We've been supporting each other. And for God, who managed to bring technology to us, we've been managing to worship throughout the year. I praise God and I say amen. May God bless all of us throughout the year. Thank you.
Sister, thank you, Brother Emmanuel. Sister Rena, followed by Brother Francis.
Good evening and happy Sabbath to all. Brother William, am I audible?
Good. Yes, sister. Yes, okay. You're all good. I can hear you loud and clear.
We would like to sing one stanza of one song. Sandra and Sandra will sing that song. After that, we will give our testimony.
Okay.
Find me now under your wing. Cover me within your mercy, and when the oceans rise and the I will soar with you above the storm. Father, you are King over the flames. I will be still, know you are God. And I will be still, know you are God.
Good evening and happy Sabbath to all once again. God has been so good to us for the past 1 year. We would like to thank God for his protection and guidance throughout the year 2020. And we hope the year 2021 would be a great blessing for each and every one of us. I would like to thank the church family for praying for my mother. We request you to all uphold my mother in your prayers in the year 2021 also, as well. God can definitely do wonders if trust in him.
We will continue to pray for Muscat SDA Church family for being with us in our difficult times, and hope God would take care of his children in 2021, even if the pandemic situation continues. We thank the technology in these difficult times, and the technology itself reveals that the God has given an alternative to praise him and to face this pandemic situation. So we would say that God has pre-planned everything to take care of us in a wonderful way. And God has given an opportunity to study from the Word of God in these difficult times. And we study many chapters from the Bible, especially 1 Samuel, 2 Samuel, James, Daniel, and now we are studying Revelation and 1 Kings. Thank God for this wonderful opportunity that we never got during our previous years to spend more time with God. And Psalms 9 verse 1 says, I will praise you, O Lord, with my whole heart. I will tell of all your marvelous works. Once again, thanking God for giving this opportunity to give thanks to the Lord. And moreover, thank God for helping us to grow spiritually by studying the Word of God. Happy Sabbath and just a happy New Year to all of you. Thank you. Amen.
Thank you, Sanran's family. And I'm specifically saying Sanran's family. Thank you. Brother Francis, followed by Brother John. John?
Happy Sabbath and Happy New Year.
Happy Sabbath and Happy New Year.
Thank you. On behalf of my family, I'd like to thank the Muscat SDA Church for being part of the bigger family. I would like to thank the Children's Ministry. In 2020, because of COVID, all the stress, the impact of for the other aspect, by taking care of the children. And may the Lord bless you and your family for the time with little one. Thank God for his provision. We want to thank him for his provision. Throughout 2020 for the encouragement and that we got every Sabbath. We look up to the Sabbath where we were present, and after the lessons we get the sermon, took us to the next Sabbath. So the year 2020 passed by without seeing that. It was a very long year, but the Lord made it short. The church family being there for us. I'd like to say something. Just
happy Sabbath and Happy New Year. I thank the Lord for protecting us during this pandemic. It has been a really long year and a hard year for many people, but I also thank the Lord for making us know that He can do anything. Many people prayed for the vaccine and for the COVID-19 to end in the year 2020. And there was a vaccine. The Lord answered our prayers. And many people were praying to God, and they had more faith in God than they ever had. I thank also for having the meetings, the online meetings for us to meet. For the children in the Sabbath school, to the sermons that we had online. Thank you.
Thank you. God bless.
Thank you, Francis and family. Brother John, George. You'll have to unmute, Brother John.
Yes, brother.
Okay, hearing you loud and clear now. And seeing you too.
Good evening and a happy Sabbath. To me, and I have all I need. Genesis 33 verse 11. According to this verse, God provided all our needs throughout this 2020. I trust He will also lead us in 2021. Happy New Year.
Good evening and happy Sabbath, everyone. Psalms 9 verse 1 says, I'll give thanks to you, Lord, with all my heart. I will tell of all your wonderful deeds. According to this verse, God has been so gracious and wonderful upon us throughout 2020. Though it is a challenging year, God has given us the good health and strength. I thank God for all the things that God has given us. And I'm sure that God will lead us and provide us in 2021 also. Happy New Year.
Happy Sabbath, church, and Happy New Year 2021 to everybody. The journey which we came across throughout this year, 2020, we really do not know what happened. We can still remember last year's testimony time. We shared a testimony saying that this year we are here, we really do not know what is our future is. God made as far as my working environment is concerned. It is in the month of November. I already shared to the church family before, and now also I want to share this again for the glory of God. To cut the story short, I have my two bosses, my immediate boss, and above him, we have our department head of section. That department head of section, he is an Iraqi guy. So he took charge of this head of section almost 5 years before. And he's a good guy, actually. But the people, in fact, around our department, they are not that much okay with other colleagues. And they, as a result of that, so they used to say this and that, and they used to give the information to my head of section in the name of complaint. And the story went on, and my head of section came to my class for the observation. Two times came, and he told John, so you need to improve a lot. Then I asked him, sir, it has been almost, I'm here almost over the past 7 years, and I strongly believe that be open, try to make one statement so that I very well can understand what is my lacking here. And he blindly said, no, actually, no, students are complaining and things like that. He was just adding these things. And I kept quiet, and he said, definitely I will come again for your observation, class observation. And before this pandemic, he came, and by God's grace, he and the other local staff came as well, and they said, she said, John, you have improved a lot. So keep it up, and you try to maintain the same, and you can still further. You can try to grow further. And I said, okay, thank you, madam. And we were thinking like, but even though she told me like this, I had in mind, as long as this Iraqi guy is here, he will try to create some problem. So I should not use the word that I want to give thanks. It is, as far as our family is concerned, we don't deserve what God is doing in our family, to be honest. But still, God is so merciful. God changed that Iraqi guy in the month of November, which nobody expected. And after 2 to 3 weeks after which he stepped down as head of section, he saw me and he was asking me, John, how are you? As if nothing had happened. So I was thinking in my mind, God can change any sort of environment. But the point is, I would like to read a verse from Jeremiah chapter 30, verse 22, it says, "And ye shall be my people, then I'll be your God." The point we are learning is that the moment we start living to exhibit the identity as God's people, definitely God, He is our God. So we experience that, and my immediate boss, now he do not know what he needs to do, because he was so comfortable with my Iraqi guy, the Iraqi guy, and now he is helpless, but he's trying to say something. But we strongly believe that still God is in control in everything. So the point, again, I want to, in conclusion, again, I want to make it very clear. If we take a stand to be His people, then God is saying, "I can be your God." So may we all be blessed by this testimony. And I'm sure that not only God is going to lead our family, definitely, God is going to lead all our families, not only in our church, in this entire world. God bless us all. Thank you.
Thank you.
Brother Williams, I would like to add a few words.
Go ahead.
Yeah. Good evening and a happy Sabbath, everyone. Happy New Year to all too. As we all have shared our testimony, God has been so gracious, so merciful towards us. And I would like to thank God for all the unconditional love that He has showered upon us during this year. This year has been a very different year, an unimaginable experience, but still God has been so gracious, so merciful towards us. There were many situations where we were thinking that what we will do, but just like the people who were traveling in the wilderness, the Israelites, God provided all our needs. There were nothing for us to worry about. So I would like to thank God for all He has done in our lives. I would like to thank God for all His protection in our extended families as well. And as we read in Philippians 4:6, "Do not be anxious about anything, but in every situation by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present your request to God. And the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus." This is not just I'm reading. We have read this verse many times. But really, God has been so merciful towards us. And I want to thank God for all that He has done. And I trust and hope that He will continue to be with us and guide us. May the name of the Lord alone be glorified.
Amen. Amen. Thank you, Sister. Sister Nalini? I'm assuming this is Sister Nalini. Yes.
Good evening. And a blessed Sabbath and a happy new year. And I'm grateful for God for being with us as a family and for guiding us, especially during this time and the platform that we use. And thankful to God that we have grown spiritually, and especially the Wednesday prayer meetings that we have. Pastor Stephen has really been an eye-opener and a blessed one, and where we share everything, and Pastor has shown us different ways of how God's leading is in our lives. And though Nalendra is away from us, we are so grateful to God that every evening that we can speak to Him and share things, and we as family we have worship together. And I just want to thank God for that and helping us to step into 2021, where we see His protection. And I just want to share and thank God for the 30 years that we've had here in Muscat and how God has led us. I remember coming for the first time, joining after marriage, just a few months. And what struck me most was about the Muscat church. We didn't tell anybody that I was coming, but somehow somebody came to know. And by the time Surendra was waiting for me to come, suddenly he sees most of the church members over there. And that has, that had impacted me a lot, because I was not known to anybody, but I was so impressed that the whole church came to receive me. And that time we were just a few people. And from that time onwards, I saw how God has led the church. So for the 25 years that I've been here, I've seen and experienced God's blessings in this oasis, in the wilderness, and this oasis. And I have learned a lot from being here in the Muscat Church, and for our four pastors who gave us spiritual blessing and nourished us. And it's made me what I am today. And I want to thank God for all the different aspects of life, the stages of three changes in this church, and how God has led us to this point where we are, so many of us. It's only praise and glory to God's name, and for helping us to be used for Him, for His service in this place. I thank God for this.
Thank you. Thank you, sister.
We worry about so many things: debt, safety, time, money, our children, our health. Sometimes we even worry about how much we worry. We worry so much that we can't sleep at night. Do you know what I'm talking about? In Luke 10, Jesus visits the house of Mary and Martha. And while Mary was sitting at the feet of Jesus, listening to Him talk, Martha was in the kitchen doing all the preparations. And Martha began to get worried because she was stuck doing everything herself. And so she came and complained to Jesus. Verse 40 says, she came up to Him and said, "Lord, do you not care that my sister has left me to do all the serving alone? Then tell her to help me." But the Lord answered and said to her, "Martha, Martha, you are worried and bothered about so many things, but only one thing is necessary. For Mary has chosen the good part, which shall not be taken away from her." Jesus tells Martha, only one thing is necessary. When we are overcome with worry, we have done what Martha did. We've forgotten the one thing, sitting at the feet of Jesus. But we so often put our trust in other things that when they don't work out the way we want them to, we start to worry. And we become afraid because we're so focused on our own agenda. And when something gets off track, we can't handle it because we've lost control. But the real problem is not that we've lost control, but that we have forgotten that we were never meant to be in control in the first place. In John 14:1, Jesus says, "Do not let your heart be troubled. Believe in God. Believe also in me." When we wait in the presence of the Lord and hand control over to Him and say, "Lord, your plans be accomplished, not mine," He reminds us that His plans have not faltered. When you put your trust in God, He will take care of you when you can't take care of yourself. Psalms 127:2b says, "For He gives to His beloved, even in His sleep." That means if you're trusting in God, when you're asleep, He's up working to make sure you're well taken care of. One time I was praying and seeking God about an important decision, because I felt like He was leading me to start working for myself, doing contract work. And I was praying and saying, "God, I don't feel like I'm going to be able to provide for my family. I don't feel like I'm going to be able to do this." But in my spirit, I knew that God was telling me, "Don't worry, I've got it." And so I got down on my knees and I said, "God, you're in control. You're our provider. I'm going to trust you with this." And the very next day after I said that, I got a phone call with someone offering enough contract work to keep me going. And I knew that it wasn't anything that I had done, it was God. Another time, I found myself burdened by the amount of work that I was having to do. I was working late hours because I was worried that if I didn't work enough, I wouldn't be able to provide for my family. And so I came before God and said, God, I'm tired. I'm working all the time. I don't know what to do. And God said to me, stop working. I've got it. And I said, stop working. I can't do that or else there won't be enough. I won't be able to provide. But God again said, stop working. I've got it. And so I took off work an hour early that day. And as soon as I took work off, I went outside and I checked the mail. And in the mailbox was a random check for $500 that I could never have predicted. And I knew that it was God that was providing for us. I'm not telling you that God doesn't want you to work. I'm telling you He doesn't want you to worry. Jesus reminds us of the most important thing. And if you will begin to seek this one thing first, you will see your problems from His perspective and not your own. I bet if an all-powerful, loving God looked down at the issues in your life, He would say, this is what all the fuss is about? Really? I can handle that. Don't worry. Isaiah 40, 31a says, yet those who wait for the Lord will gain new strength. They will mount up with wings like eagles.
Good evening. Happy Sabbath and Happy New Year.
Good evening, happy Sabbath.
Yeah, we and Elder Surendra informed me to speak and say something about the history of Moscow Church. I was really thinking of what I'm telling because, you know, if we are getting younger, so some part of the history I can't remember. But I can say something what I started here before when we started here in Muscat and how the church growing. During the time when we are together, I remember Brother George and Sister Chetel, and also Sister Sylvie is there, and Brother Elvis, Marlene, Judith, and Myrna, and myself. So we started together to meet the house of Chetel. Then the following weeks again, Sabbath, then we meet the house of the home of Brother Elvis. And I really happy about what we did last night for the anniversary because it reminds me a lot. And I didn't expect that it will reach 30 years, really. So there is a purpose why we are still here in Muscat. So we thanks God for that. Say amen to that because the church growing more because from 5 to 10 members, now we are getting around 100 members in the church. Same into that. So the thing which I have to say, it's already know about what is the story before. So I just want to emphasize the most important here in our children. And really, I appreciate for our elders that really they are teaching our children professionally. And I never forget for that. Even my daughter, she's growing up with full of knowledge in this church. And I saw the potentials of our children because our children is our leaders in the future. So we need to teach them and guide them. Because if we are teaching them with nothing, so they will not learn in the presence of God. So I never forget with my daughter, Lovell. She grown up from 2 years old up to this time that she graduated her course in conservatory of music, major in voice. So I really thank, especially for leadership of our elders, especially for Brother Surendra, and our teachers for our Sabbath school, and our children. Really, I'm really happy for that, that I observe that a lot of children, they are really growing with full of knowledge and wisdom from above. So I cannot say to all what the history, but this is the most important which I'd like to share, that I'm so happy for that, for the Muscat Church, what we are showing the people with our faith. Because in Hebrews 11:1, it says, now faith is the assurance of things hoped for, the conviction of things not seen. So we have to pray for all our children in Muscat Church and all the members, that we will hand in hand to study the Word of God, to continue to serve the people, especially to those people who are not in the same faith. This is my prayer, that even though in the midst of pandemic, but we are still meeting together, that I hope that all of us will be blessed. Thank you very much. Good evening.
I want to, you know, since a few minutes more, I want to share something about the Muscat Church that many of us may not know. John will remember this for certain. You know, we were the first church in the Gulf region to be, I've been told it's the Middle East, but I know definitely for the Gulf, that has been legally recognized by the government. We were the first church. Now that was a miracle. From 1990 till 1995, we had every year written to the PCO asking for legal recognition, because the recommendation had to go from the PCO to the government. And for 5 years consecutively, the PCO rejected our request. In 1995, when Pastor Steve Brown, who was on line last night with us, he said, come, let us put in a request, but we will do it with prayer. And the church started praying. And in August, he went and approached the PCO. And the new administrator had come in. And he said, why not? Y'all put in a request. And he said something. I said, I have the greatest admiration for the Seventh-day Adventist Church. So we put in our request. We wrote a letter. But he said, let me also tell you something. The same council that has rejected your request for 5 years is the same council that is in hand. So he said, and one of the reasons they give us is that y'all are a sect. So let's go ahead. We'll pray about it. We sent the request. And the meeting was on September 11th. On September 12th at 2 o'clock in the afternoon, I cannot forget that, we had a call from the PCO, And the first thing the administrator told me was your church praying yesterday? And believe me, the church was praying. Don will remember, everywhere we had members, the members got together and prayed and said, Lord, give us, we don't want to be an underground church. We want to be a legal entity in this country for your name's honor and glory. I said, you are absolutely right. We were praying. He said, the committee, the council, which had for 5 years unanimously rejected y'all's request, yesterday unanimously accepted to accept y'all as a legal church in Oman. You know, we just couldn't but praise God. And I remember that very evening, the same groups got together to pray and praise God. And, you know, God has been faithful to us. That's why, you know, I always have this absolute assurance that God has a purpose for us in this country to bring this, the joy of salvation to this nation. You know, even during this pandemic, when I was talking to the PCO about Pastor Ham's visa, again they reiterated, they said, we hold the Seventh-day Adventist Church up as an example to all the churches in Oman. And we know the reason why. He said, number one reason is yours unity. Different countries, different nations, different backgrounds, but y'all are united, which is amazing. Second thing is, we have recognized your church as a praying church. And the third thing, which I had not known till they told me this, said, whenever we come for a request to help somebody, y'all never ask which church do they belong to, which community they belong to, which nationality are they. Y'all help. Y'all help. And we always uphold this to the other churches. He said, y'all's church is the church that has lasted for 30 years without breaking up. So, you know, when Don was talking, I couldn't but, you know, thank God for what he has called us. Every one of you have been called into this country for a purpose. Some for 5 years, some for 10 years, some for 1 year, some for 2 years. But God has brought you all here for a specific purpose. Never, ever forget that. And as long as our intention is to lift his name on high, he will keep you as long as he has planned for you to bring glory and honor to his name. Okay, we have just a few minutes more. And there's anybody else who'd like to speak?
Yes, any other testimonies before we go through, please?
Good evening, everybody.
Good evening, sister.
Yeah, this is, can I join?
Yes, go ahead.
Yeah, happy Sabbath to all. Yeah, I just want to share some experience while I'm here. I'm here for almost 9 years in Oman, and I really thank God for the blessings in my life, that despite of the situation, that I'm a single mother, but I praise God always because, you know, last year is what it was, a tough year for all of us, and our job security is not secured at all. So it was like a blessings that still I am here. My visa was renewed in October last year, 2020. It was renewed on time. No questions asked whatsoever. And it was my great blessings from God. And I just want to share quickly about my experience about my friend. He's a Catholic, but he's from other nationality. So it was also a tough year for him to come back to Oman since he was locked down in his own country. And then because of this MUFA thing, it was like a roller coaster, situation for him. So one time he asked me for a prayer. So he wants me to like just to pray for him so that his MUFA will be approved. And it was really difficult that time because MUFA is required when you are outside Oman for 180 days. So he was more than 180 days outside Oman. So the crucial thing was he flew from his country back to Oman without MUFA approval at all. But his MUFA thing was on process. So I was just like keep praying in our Bible study group. Sister Tricia is part of it also. So I just prayed to God that Lord, if it is your desire for him to come back because he is really needed in the company to work, so let him be in Oman. So he flew in Oman without MUFA at all. So when he came, when he was in Dubai waiting for his flight coming back to Oman, this was the crucial thing for him. So he asked everything only from me. So he was coordinating with me from day one up to the last time he came back to Oman. So this was like a miracle what happened to him because MUFA was very difficult to get approval of MUFA. And he applied MUFA just 14 days before he will fly back to Oman. His MUFA was processed 11 days short of 3 days, which is the normal processing time, working days time. So it was really like, you know, and when he was in the airport, he was able to come in Oman without anything on his hand, only on everything on the cell phone. And he was like calling at me, thank you so much for your prayers, because God is using you to help me to pray for this kind of a thing. So he told me, you know, you are a positive influence to my life, you are a positive friend to me. And then he started to like, you know, I'm started to share with him verses in the Bible, and I started to pray with him. And up to this time, I am so happy that he's starting to recognize God in his life. So I'm praying that God will really like bring him closer. He will study the Bible. He will read the scriptures. So he will be blessed with the words of God as well. So it is the testimony that I have with him, which is I told him, you can share your testimony with your colleagues, because when he came back to Oman, most of our colleagues is asking him, can you help us? How did you come back to Oman with MUFA, with processed within 11 days only? Who helped you? Who gave you who's that person who helped you? So he told me, just you have to do to the normal process. So this is the testimony that I can testify that if you are really standing faithful to God, even if you are praying to that person who is not really of the same faith, he will do something for him because you are bringing him to God. So this is my testimony, that it really like it's a powerful testimony for him and also for me as a person, because if we are really living with God in our lives, people can see it, and then they will start to recognize God in their lives. Thank you so much. Good evening.
Thank you for sharing, Sister Joy. Do we have anybody else who would like to share?
Okay, thank you for sharing.
I think there are others, Ella. Just a moment. There were someone else who wanted to come on.
No.
Let's give them some time. Ruth Joy? Is there Ruth Joy? No.
Okay. Okay. Thank you all for being online, for sharing, for being for coming through. I know some of us may not have spoken in words, but the Lord knows your heart. He knows your testimony. Before we close, you know, I want to also tell you that there was a tremendous response to our service yesterday from those who came in from the different parts of the world. There was a tremendous response. Our pastors were so happy who had served in the Muscat Church. Well, we were fortunate to have four of our pastors online, and they were so thrilled what the Lord has done through y'all in this land. As I said, and I've said, the church first prayed for legal recognition. The Lord gave it. The church prayed for the change of the weekend. The Lord gave it. The church has prayed for a pastor's visa. The Lord gave it. Now the only thing we pray for is for this land to be claimed for eternity, for the joy of salvation assured in Christ to be on their faces. And this is why you are here. All your testimonies are seeds that you can plant in people's hearts, because nothing can take away from your testimony, because that's something that you have experienced. In 1 John 5:11, you have the greatest testimony. The greatest testimony that you have life assured, eternal life assured in Christ Jesus. Before we close, Brother William, you have something to say?
Yes, I can't allow the testimony service to close without sharing it, because I've shared this platform on so many times. I wanted everybody else to get an opportunity to go ahead before me. My favorite Bible verse, Psalms 37:25, says, I have been young and now I am old, yet have I not seen the righteous forsaken, nor the seed begging bread. Now, 2020 has been a challenging year for many people. And for me personally, it's an opportunity for me to walk closer with the Lord. There were lots and lots of opportunities and for God to show himself to me. And as many of you may not know, in last year, I had changed my job. And this, in 2019, I changed my job. And just after the pandemic started, they said to me, well, this is a challenging situation. The last person in is the first person out. And I got that information the 19th of May. The 19th of May. And we all know what it is like. It wasn't really it wasn't really a release from the job. It was a downscaling. And so I moved from a full-time to a part-time. And I had the option to move on. And the situation was not a livable one for me. And it was, I say this to you, that on the 19th of May, I got that. And on the 3rd June, the final day of work, I got a new job. And that wasn't for anything that I did, but it was only for the grace of God. And I just want to continue to praise him and to glorify him and to lift him up. But most importantly, I know that we've got we talk about the challenges of the COVID-19. But I want to say to you guys that it has been a blessing for me in many ways. And one of that way is the opportunity for me to study God's words deeper. I don't know, not many of us join in on the Wednesday evening study, but I implore each of you to come and join with us as pastor and us study in depth the Word of God. And also our Sabbath school lesson on a Sabbath morning. Now, the things that God has revealed to me as an individual over this past year, that revelation has not been in store before. And I just want to say, yes, as soon as we settle in to something and the pandemic, some people settling into the pandemic and just life goes on the same way. But I just want to say to you that the Lord has been holding my hand throughout this time, and He has been guiding me, and the opportunity has arisen where I am now able to know God's character, who He is. He is a God of love. His character is a love. His character allows us to be free beings, so freedom, and is a character of truth. And those three characteristics of Christ allow us to draw closer to Him. I just want to implore the church to continue to pray for me, yes, as I continue this pathway with God. Thank you.
Before Dawn sings our song, I want to remind the church, we are the recipients of God's legacy. What is His legacy to us? He has taken away our sin. He has forgiven us. He has given us a clear conscience. He has given us righteousness. He has given us eternal life. He has raised us up to the heavenly places. We will live with Him eternally when sin, death, and the devil are destroyed at His second coming. And what, in response to this, what could the church, the family of God, say? To God be the glory.
You have done. Say
Before we have our closing prayer, I want to remind you all of a statement that is found in the book Life Sketches, page 96. We have nothing to fear for the future, except as we shall forget the way the Lord has led us and his teachings in our past history. Shall we bow our heads in prayer? Our Father who art in heaven, we come before thee with hearts full of praise and gratitude, Father, for you have been faithful to us. We praise you, Father, for the testimonies that have been spoken, for the testimonies that have come from the heart, which have been recognized by you, Father. We praise you for your Holy Spirit that has accepted our testimonies and presented it before your throne as sweet-smelling incense, Father, for the songs that have arisen, for everyone, every family that's here. We praise your holy name. Father in heaven, your Queen Esther said, you have brought me to the palace for such a time as this. And we recognize, Father, that whatever our intention may have been to come here, we now recognize that you have brought us here for such a time as this. And may we be faithful to you, Father. May your name be glorified. May your name be honored. Father, all that we have been asking is that this nation, a nation that knew the joy of salvation, a nation that produced your model to the universe in Job, we pray, Father, that this nation will have the joy and the smile of salvation again on their face. And Father in heaven, ability, we have none. Availability, we are available, Father, to do as you demand and as you will, so that we will present to this nation a true picture of the Jehovah God, the God we serve. We praise you for the joy of salvation that you have given us, assured in Christ Jesus. We praise you for the joy of a new year that we have to lift your name on high. And Father in heaven, we praise you that even while on this earth, we are sitting in heavenly places, clothed, cleansed by the blood of Jesus, clothed in his robe of righteousness. And Father in heaven, we praise you that we are in your presence. And the word of God says that by beholding, we are changed. And so we praise you, Father, that even as we behold you, Father, you change us so that we can be a true picture of you to this nation, to our families, to our church families, and to those around us. May your name and your name alone be glorified, for we come to you in the name of Jesus. Amen. Thank you all for joining in, for being a part of this amazing service, both yesterday and today. And I pray that you will have a blessed year ahead, a year of privilege to glorify God's name. And remember the promise we claim, if I be lifted up, if God, Jesus, if the name of Jesus be lifted up, what has he promised? That he will draw all men to him. At this time, you're welcome to unmute, wish and greet each other in the name of Christ.